I miss you guys a lot. I haven't been making videos in a very long time. However, I'm back now. So here is the topic for today. We're going to look at why somebody talks about money, why somebody starts a business, why somebody should work for that matter. And I think for me, most importantly than money, it should be passion driven. You should be wanting to serve, you should be wanting to do it for another person, and in turn you get monetary compensation. So it shouldn't be a money driving thing. Like for instance, me doing financial coaching, number one, it's because of passion. It's because I enjoy helping people with their budgets, with their expenditure, managing their savings, looking at out for the future spending or future achievement in terms of savings or investments. So it's an exciting thing for me to do. So that's why I'm saying it shouldn't always be money driven. It can always be a passion driven. And when it's driven by passion, you know, money drives behind it. It shouldn't be money first and then passion. It should be passion driven by money. Numerous times, a lot of us find ourselves in either jobs or doing something that we don't really want to do, but it's because we don't have a choice. We really need that finances, or we really need a financial support, financial help, and that's why we end up being in a certain job. And that's also the reason why most of the time you find things like customers being dissatisfied with the service. Now, being dissatisfied already, you need to find out what is the underlying reason why somebody would offer a dissatisfying service to the customer. Most of the time is because they're only there because they need to get a salary. They're only there for the income part of it, and not necessarily because they have the passion or they enjoy to help. Look, it's very much amazing to help a fellow Namibian, to help a fellow sister, a fellow brother, just to achieve their next goal. Whether you're selling in a store, whether you are in the parking lot, whether you're doing financial coaching, whether you're in a banking situation, or whether you're in an insurance company, the fact that you are serving the next person should be your driver and not necessarily the income that you get behind it. Trust me, the income comes after it. Good service, we know if you get good service, especially those who get tips would testify with me that if you give a good service to a customer, they are most likely to give you a great tip. If you give them a bad customer service, they're most likely to give you nothing. So it should be helping people, passion, and passionate to help others, that should drive the money, and not the money to drive what you do and how you do it. Till next time, guys, we still have a lot of video to do, a lot of financial coaching topics to cover. So stay tuned. I didn't go. I'm still with you guys. So see you next time in our next video. Bye-bye.